What's up, guys and gals? Welcome back to the Nerdcastle for the next episode of Stardew Valley. Winter is what I expected. Winter is what I expected from this game. We're not really doing a whole lot right now. I find that the best way for us to spend our time is maybe I'll go back down to the deep dungeon today and see what I can pull out of there, because I feel like we didn't rightly spend a lot of time in the deep dungeon. Well, our energy's kind of low. Maybe we'll wait till tomorrow. We'll wait till tomorrow. It's okay. Let me unload some of this stuff. We've got the cockle right there. We've got 10 frozen geodes, which is really, really good for us. The pine cones, I don't think those go in the fridge unless you're looking to munch on something a little crunchy today. Having a really good week right now. I'm in a really great mood, and so I'm happy to have you all here. I feel tremendously blessed at the moment, and things seem to be going my way right now. So if things are not going your way right now in life, hang in there. That's all that I can say, because a month ago, things were not going my way. I had family in and out of surgery for, like, problems. I had real-life issues. It blows over. It's easy to lose sight of that. Trust me when I say I'm a person, I get depressed real easy. I get bummed out real easy. I get down real easy. I'm gonna light that up too, just to keep it warm out here. And sometimes it's hard to lose sight of the fact that, like, everything is temporary. Nothing's gonna last forever. You know what I mean? Not even us as human beings. Not even us as human beings. But not everything lasts forever. If you're having a bad week or a bad month or a bad year, there's a whole lot more in front of you, you know? Don't do anything drastic. Talk to somebody. Have a friend over. Have a little chat. Just, you know, don't get too bogged down in it, because I've been there and I know what that feels like, and it took me a long time to learn that sometimes you just gotta get out of your own headspace, do something you enjoy for a little while, do something outside your comfort zone. That's a big thing for me. Go outside and just walk up a hill in the sunlight and just realize that the world is a beautiful place, and there's some green grass out there, and there's some swinging trees, and there's some little birdies twerping and all that kind of stuff. Welcome on back. Welcome. I feel like I'm 3 minutes into the episode and I haven't really talked about anything. So our plan for today, I'd like to go back down to the magma lair. I feel like I did not spend much time in the magma lair because we blew through it really fast because I was just trying to clear the dungeon before winter got here. I would like to check it out. I would like to see what else is down there and what sort of things are available for our perusal. I'm going to drop off the geodes here because we've got different geotypes with us right now. I'll probably sell off about 10 of the mayos. I think today is the wizard's birthday. We do have some basic farm stuff we need to do today. We've got to be getting closer to, I think, the winter solstice celebration as well. Oop, that does not go in there. Storing our wood next to our food. That would explain the woody taste that all of our chocolate has. I left a bowl full of chocolate next to my computer. No joke, this is the weirdest thing that I've ever seen in my life. I had a bowl of chocolates, like, next to my computer because I like to graze. I have a sweet tooth, like, legitimately, like, Belgian and Swiss chocolate and stuff like that, or, like, just simple stuff, like, See's candy or whatever. I have a sweet tooth. I have a sweet tooth that runs real, real deep. And so, anyways, I keep chocolate around at all times. That's just, like, what I do. Hey, Fickle Farmer, I'm sorry to bug you again, but I need another favor. I got a new hammer, and I want to try it on a variety of metals. Could you smelt an iron bar and bring it to me? Yeah, I'll take that right there. That sounds good. I'll take the iron bar over to Clint today. We'll run some errands first because obviously we don't have that much to do around here. Do I not have any laying around? I think I've got to have them in my metals drawer here. Yeah, there it is. We'll bring an iron bar on over to that side because our bars go hard. You know me. Here at the Nerd Castle, I put the bar in embarrassment. So let's grab all of our mayo out of there. I will probably sell off... Let's go 11 of those, because obviously I don't think we're going to need that much. I'll sell off a Nautiloid real fast. Completely and totally different than the Isoloid, logically, but we'll talk about that a little bit later. Nothing to worry about for right now. Chickens are happy. They're in here, I assume, crapping on the floor and making all kinds of a mess. We'll go ahead and pet them each day to make sure that we got their hearts on the up and up, because much like Link, I am not happy with just a few hearts. You got to get more. All I want is more. All I want is more. I'm a giant real big fish fan, by the way. I grew up during that phase where ska was like the shit, and it never came back. That's the weirdest part about ska, is that it was here and it had like the fourth wave or whatever the hell it was called, and then it just like kind of teetered off, and I don't know what happened with all of it. I think we just milked that one right there. Do you not have any milk today, or did I just target him properly? There we go. That's what I like to see. Get those cows all taken care of. Everybody's happy and taken care of. They got their pets in. I went out to a guy's house this week. And oh my god, I got to see how the other side lives. I got to see how the other half lives, and it was pretty amazing. And so anyways, I went over to this house. I'm not going to talk about... What is that right there? An orange. Oh, cool. We got a naranja. Okay, so we got ourselves a little bit of an orange right there. That'll be pretty cool. I think I can use that for one of my collections. And that's probably... Yeah, there it is right there. So we've got cheese. We've got an orange. I had the apricot. I could have solved this right now. I've got the honey, though. Let's go ahead, and with the wild honey, we're going to take this over, and we're going to do our little collection here today. I also think it's the wizard's birthday. So I'm going to try and get there on the blackberry jelly. Perfect. I think we should be able to bang this one out real fast. I'm sure they're probably not going to give me anything too fantastic for it, because as you weave your way through the game, there's a lot of little things that you can pick up. I'm feeling happy about the fact we've got a lot of our fields taken care of. Let me get some cheese brewing, too, because cheese and refined goods have really been the only way that we're breaking even here in the winter. We've been making money, but we've been spending money, too. We got this upgraded barn a couple episodes ago. If you didn't check out that episode, definitely recommend you give it a look-see. We started our own little orchard over on this side. I'm planning on getting a couple more trees by the end. I don't remember what kind of tree I got, but I don't care if I diversify a little bit. That's a little bit of extra money every single day. There's a long, long run-up cost on an orchard, but once you got it set up, it's going to give you a constant supply so that you can make preserves if you really wanted to do that. And then with the excess, you can go through and then you can just sell it off. I mean, that's that, and make a little bit of money. And I'd be lying if I said it doesn't sell for too bad of a cost. Today should be the wizard's birthday, I think. I should probably check the board. Was it today or was it tomorrow? Too lazy to walk across town in my Donald Duck hat, so we're just gonna do it today. Oh, it's my birthday today? I guess it is. Thanks. This is very, very nice. Did that give us a full heart? Oh, really? We gave him something that jumped us up. Like, holy balls. That jumped us up by 3 hearts. We gave him something he loved on his birthday? That's like instant friend zone material. Normally, I'm trying not to be inside the friend zone, but when it comes to the wizard, I don't feel like his sex moves are on the same level. Like, he's at, like, a C-. I feel like I'm, like, an A-. I mean, I don't want to overestimate my skills or anything like that. But I just don't want one member to feel like they're not getting something out of this. You know what I mean? You can't be a charity. That's not what life is about. You got to do a little bit of humanitarian work, but not too much. You do too much, that's when you be getting yourself in trouble. Let's go off to the right-hand side, and I'm going to drop off that iron bar with Clint. And then it's deep down into the dungeon for us on the way by. We'll probably try to drop off this collection so that that's getting done, too. We're almost done with our first year. I almost gave this series the boot. Wasn't so sure about it. We got a lot of stuff coming up in the future. There are going to be some new games coming out, but I think I'll probably give other stuff the boot first. Stardew Valley is something I'm very passionate about. When you're passionate about something on your channel, it's so rare that you have a game that just ensorcels you. There we go. I felt like that might be a little over the top to say ensorcelled. But every now and again, you get a game that you're just absolutely in love with, and you kind of just want to play it all the time. Hey, it's the iron bar I asked for. It looks strong. Perfect. Thanks, Fickle Farmer. I appreciate it. Got our fare for Clint. He gave us 500 bucks for a metal bar. That's cool. That takes us over the tent. What's the skull key right there? What does that do? You found a strange-looking key in the bottom of the mines. Discover the purpose of the skull key. Okay. Demetrius still wants a melon. We're actually kind of running out as she wants a pale ale. And then Jody wanted a cauliflower. I'll have to keep that in mind. I think we can't grow melon till summer, but cauliflower, I think, is spring. I'll have to check on the crop listings once spring actually gets here, but let's go. I think it's on this map, actually, so we got to cut to the left right now. See if we can drop off some of these goodies. Got all of these little things in here. I'll probably try to drop off the puffer fish while I'm here, too. Now, I called the other one honey. It didn't call it wild honey, so I don't know if we've got wiggle room on that one. I've seen some things in the game that you've got wiggle room on, and then other ones, it seems like you don't have wiggle room. This is going to be for the pantry, and so we'll go to the left, and it's not for the arts and crafts room. That's all nice and done. Instead, I think this is the pantry. Yeah, there it is. The artisan bundle. Okay, it took it. And then we got that right there. We got an orange. We got a cheese. That would have almost got me there. Milk won't go in there. All right, well, we did our best. I mean, we went in deep on it. I'm going to save the other stuff just in case I need to eat down in the dungeon. But we're halfway through the day right now, and I'd like to have a little bit of quality time with the deep down bottom of the magma dungeon. Oh, that was weird. My character was walking to the left, but I had no finger on the keyboard. I was like, what is going on right now? The world is a confusing and magical place where things are happening without my permission. Okay, well, maybe we'll sort that out a little bit later. Let's head off to the left over here. I think we're sitting on some pretty good stuff right now. Life is feeling tremendously blessed at the moment. Our stream has been blowing up. If you haven't seen the stream, it's been crazy. We've been doing like 200 follows a stream. I don't know if you know, like, metrics on Twitch, but, like, guys like Cryotic do 200 follows a stream. Like, the stream has been absolutely blowing up, and it's so nice. I was talking to somebody about this the other day, where sometimes it feels like you hustle really, really hard, but, like, you don't get what you want out of an endeavor. Like, you feel like it's not going anywhere. You feel like you're struggling, or, like, maybe you don't have it. You know, you don't feel like you have what it takes. And then all of a sudden, overnight, you get validated by just a fantastic community that helps carry you, you know? One of those one pair of footsteps type things. And it's so cool to watch that community take off and become something more. And so I greatly appreciate it. But if you wanted to stop by and become a part of that community, I'm at twitch.tv/splattergatgaming. You should definitely check it out. Give it a little follow on over there, because my streams are kind of sporadic. They're all over the place. I don't have a solid schedule right now, because when I was streaming on a schedule, I posted about this on Twitter. I felt like streaming had become like a job-like thing for me. And when I'm trying to have fun and kind of entertain people and make them smile, I can't feel like it's a job. That's something that I've learned about myself, is that I can't feel like it's a job, because then I've got just this overbearing feeling like punch in, punch out, you know what I mean? And by getting rid of the schedule, now it feels much more sporadic. It feels a lot more fun. It feels a lot more like spur of the moment, you know what I mean? And to me, that makes me feel more spontaneous, makes me feel a little bit happier, it makes me feel a little bit more light in the saddle, loose in the spurs, and it helps me entertain better. And so right now, I'm just not having a schedule, but it's been working out pretty cool. I am going to get a schedule at some point, but I'm going to try and find one that works better around Roll For It, because right now, with the newly, because Roll For It is a big deal. Like, Roll For It is a thing that we as channels, if you don't know what Roll For It is, Roll For It is my tabletop show that I've started up with Enter Elysium. Avec, it belongs to all of us, so I shouldn't say I have started up. This is a thing that we've all gone in and we've all shook hands on it. We've all said this is a thing that we want to do long term, you know what I mean? We want this to grow and become an edifice of internet entertainment. And it has. It's become a very, very cool thing that we've all done every single week, but it's at a precarious place in the middle of the week for me. And so I think it was very, very haphazard of me to just, like, put it in the middle of the week and then expect nothing else to change and to expect that the rest of my schedule wasn't going to suffer for it. I should have thought about it a little better. It was a mistake on my part. And so anyways, kind of getting rid of the schedule, the second part of that is that I was very much, oh, you can blow up the stone on his back? I never realized you could do that. That's a cool little attention to detail type thing. I never realized that you could do that. We've got a magnet ring right there, and it might be a higher quality one. I'll take a look at it in just a second, and we'll get a feel for it. The magnet ring increases your radius for collecting items. I like the rings we have right now. I'm not looking to suck at the moment. A little bit of suckage is not something that I'm looking for. And so anyways, the second part of that is that I was feeling stressed because of the changes that came as a result of Roll For It. And I should have thought about it better. I should have planned better, and I should have known better. I've been doing this for a long time, and it's funny to me how you don't learn lessons. Like, oh, it was a plane. Okay, I live right next to an airbase. I live right next to Travis Air Force Base. And so sometimes planes will buzz the city. They actually have an agreement right now with the airbase that the planes will fly below a certain level. It didn't used to be like that when I was a kid. When I was a kid, used to get buzzed by C5s and all kinds of stuff going over the city. And it was so loud, like it would rattle the windows and stuff. And people that weren't from here, they'd be like, how do you just get used to that? How do you sleep through that? And I'd be like, oh, your body tunes it out. Like, it's not like a conscious thing that you do. It's just that after a while, your ears just tune it out. Like, you don't even notice it anymore. Like, you don't wake up in the middle of the night, or if you grow up around it especially, it's not that big of a deal. Like, it's not I'm probably going to sell a lot of this gold ore, by the way, while we're down here. I will more than likely throw that to a vendor or something, or throw it in the crate after we get out of here. Now, we aren't getting a lot of coal, but what we are getting right now is we are getting a pretty substantial amount. Oh, our health is looking kind of bad. I didn't realize how much damage I was taking. Okay. We're kind of in the danger zone right now. Luckily, I'm in a spot where... Let me put the cheese up here. Just in case... Just in case we have issues. I want to have that ready to go in case I need to eat food. I don't know. Yeah. It'll be alright. I'm sure it'll be okay. What am I worried about? What was I talking about previously? Damn it, I lost my groove. I'm in a very Cusco-like moment right now where my groove has been... It's been thrown off, man. I got a groove, and... When it gets thrown off, I don't even know where to pick it up again. Oh, yeah. I was probably just going to throw most of this gold. Oh, yeah. That's what I was worried about. We're about to get a bat swarm, so we need to be very, very careful. Especially if we get multiples at the same time. We need to have an exit. Yeah, we'll just kind of cleave on these guys for a second. It'll go away in a minute, but we don't want to focus too heavily right now on mining or anything like that. Basically, we sort of want to pick a direction and get after it. We are going to get a bunch of bat wings out of this, which is not nearly as cool as you might think if you read Batman comics. Nope, not going to get a bat wing out of this. Not that kind of bat wing anyways. That'd be so badass if you could become such a baller farmer that, like, you end up with, like, the Bugatti of, like, aircraft. Oh, yeah, Travis Air Force Base. That's what I was talking about. Travis Air Force Base is near where I live, and so planes are constantly buzzing on by, and it's pretty noisy. Can be anyways, but in the last 10 years or so, I think the cities around here got together and kind of petitioned the airbase to kind of, like, keep it on the down. It is noisy. It is really, really noisy, and I think it does affect people moving into the area. There's a lot of people that are like, we'd like to move here and bring our business here or whatever, but it's so noisy and I can't sleep, and it seems like a little thing. I think if you're bringing a business around, you're trying to make money. If you're money hungry and money focused, you ain't worried about the noisiness of planes or whatever. But it doesn't seem to be as noisy as it used to be, and I don't think it's like a ear blind type thing. I think it's probably just, it seems like the planes fly higher than they used to. Like, they used to flat out, like, buzz the city sometimes, like, flying really, really, really low. Not anymore. Not anymore. Grab that guy right there, looking good. Oh, another Omni Geode. We might be able to come out of this one on top. We didn't get a ton of red geodes here, which is what I was down in the dungeon for. I was hoping for a lot more red geodes, but you know what? We've got a fistful of these little bastards right now, and we might be able to pull something a little bit more sexy out of the dungeon. I don't know. We'll keep an eye on it together. This looks like the place for a bomb. I'm gonna drop it and run. Oh, almost blew myself up. Almost blew myself up. We got close. Got very, very close on that one. Let's dig down south and see if we can't get ourselves anything sexy in here. A little bit more gold. How much gold did we come out of this with? Because I think they sell for a pretty solid amount. We got 40 gold out of the dungeon while we were down here, and I am interested in, like, making more money. Our character's kind of broke right now. We're going to be buying a lot of seeds, like a lot of seeds once we get to spring. I don't know what to use the skull key for. We tried it on all of the dungeon doors and whatnot. Didn't seem to be too fruitful. We might be able to ask Gunter about it, or maybe there's an event we have to get involved with first. Oh, we got a treasure room down here. Good, that might help out with that little coal deficit that we've been feeling lately. I will probably take care of this ye old-fashioned way with explosives. That's ye old-fashioned way with explosives, or some kind of, like, accelerant. Good, not a bad day. We're going to be out of here at a reasonable hour, too, so that's the other part that I'd be a little bit worried about. I'm going to run off this way. So we blow that all open. Not too bad. We got combat boots. Those give us 3 defense, but compared to the 4 and 4 that we have going on right now, we got some rubies, we got some emeralds, but they're not going to be star quality. So unfortunately, we won't be able to put them on the road and charge them a 10% fee on all of the bookings, but nah. Sometimes that's the way she goes, Rick. That's just the way she goes. Let's go back up to the surface. We are dunsies here. I wanted to get back to the house early enough to where I don't have to stress about our energy and our health coming back. I think they're open. I don't think they're open that late, though. We'll try to drop off the combat boots and the weaponry at a different time. I think we can throw it in the crate, though, too, can't we? Maybe not. Maybe not. We didn't do a whole lot of reputation stuff today, and so unfortunately, I hope our reputation is not suffering. We should make a little bit of money. I'm going to load up some of this stuff into the crate before we leave. We got white algae and a bunch of other stuff down in there. But by and large, I feel like we had a pretty productive day. I'll more than likely, oh, our maple syrup is up too, but our inventory is full. I'll reset that in just a second. I want to get that harvested so that tonight counts towards the cooldown. All right, so let's throw the gold in there. Cave carrots, yup. Sounds good. Anything else that we picked up down in there is fine by me. Throw anything and everything inside of there because I don't want to carry it with me. And it's easier than organizing my inventory in the middle of an episode, too. That's the second half of it. We'll go back over here. We're going to harvest out some of this maple syrup. I like how you get a different note each time you pick that stuff up. What's right there? Why can't I walk in between that? Shit. Oh, there's a sapling right there. Let me murder that real fast. Murder it dirty. Ooh, yeah, that's a good harvest for us. 11 maple syrups. I think I need those for bee boxes, but I only need two or three. So I think I'll probably... Oh, we got our preserves ready to go, too. I'll harvest those in the morning. Not bad. Not bad. I got more money out of that than I thought that I would. And so, I think I'm pleased with it. Takes us back up to 15K or so. Got these preserves, spice berry jelly, and some apricot jelly. I'll probably just get rid of those since they have no use for us right now. Dear Figgle Farmer, I would like to give you some information about an upcoming event, the Feast of the Winter Star. It's time for the community to come together and think back on all the good fortune we've had this year. A favorite tradition is the secret gift exchange, where everyone in the town is randomly assigned to somebody else. On the day of the festival, everybody brings a gift for their secret friend and surprise them with something special. This year, your secret friend is... Caroline. Don't tell anybody. The feast will take place on the 25th from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. at the town square. I'll see you then, Mayor Lewis. But who gets Mayor Lewis? See, that's what sucks about organizing events is sometimes you don't get to be a part of it, you know what I mean? Like, I always feel bad for the people. Like, sometimes the people that hold us together are the most alone. You know what I mean? Like, I don't know if anybody has that friend, but it's sad to think about. And I try to go out there for the person that's, like, the leader in our group. And I can think of who it is right now. I can think of who it is right now. And sometimes people are so busy trying to make sure everybody else is okay that nobody checks to make sure that they're okay. And that always seems shitty to me. Everybody deserves for somebody to ask them if they're all right every now and again. And so I try to be that guy in my life. And if you don't do that, think about it. Every now and again, just check in with your friends, you know? Hit your friends list on Facebook. Find somebody that's not feeling so great and seems like they're having a hard time and just be like, hey, what's going on, man? You want to talk? I know a lot of people do it because they're attention-seeking or whatever. And they put up kind of like those shitty cryptic posts and whatnot. But still, why take the chance? Just hit them up and be like, hey, what's going on, man? You want to go grab Taco Bell or something? It's on me. Let's go just like sit and catch up on the old days or something. Just have an afternoon. But either way, I will see you all later. This is going to be the end of our episode. My name is Splattercat. Thank you for joining me here at the Nerd Castle for the next episode of Stardew Valley. I am very much looking forward to seeing you all in the next episode. I hope you will stop by. I dearly hope that you will, and I will see you all later. Bye, everybody.